Dear students, let's do some questions related to frequency table and cumulative frequency table. A cumulative frequency table is given for the ungrouped data. The following table gives the frequency distribution of marks obtained by 28 students in a particular test. The table is given here. In the table, marks are given as 30, 31, 32 and 33, and the frequency corresponding to each of the mark is given as 5, 7, 10 and 6. What is the meaning of frequency here? Yes, there are 5 students having the mark 30. We have to construct a cumulative frequency table for this given data. Let's write the given vertical table in a vertical way. So here is the mark and frequency we wrote. Now to write cumulative frequency table, we have to rearrange this class interval. So we rearrange the marks into marks less than 30, less than 31, less than 32 and less than 33. Now we have to find the cumulative frequency. How to find the cumulative frequency? For mark 30, the frequency corresponding to mark 30 is 5. Then, marks less than or equal to 30 is also 5. But, for the next one, marks less than 30, 31. Marks less than 31 means the 5 students also got the marks less than 30, right? So, we need to add 5 and 7 together. So, it is 12. Now to find the frequency of marks less than or equal to 32, how many students are there? We need to consider the 3 frequencies together. So it will be 5 plus 7 plus 10, 22. Then what will be the last one? The marks less than 33 equal to, we need to add all the frequencies together. So it will be 5 plus 7 plus 10. 10 plus 6, it is 28. This is how we will form cumulative frequency table from an ungrouped data. Next question is given here. It's a grouped data. The grouped frequency table is given here and the frequencies are also given here. We have to construct a cumulative frequency table for the given data. Now, look at the table. What are given there? The mass in gram. It is divided into class interval as 10 to 14. What is the meaning of 10 to 14? It is 10 gram to 14 gram, 15 gram to 19 gram, 20 gram to 24 gram, 25 gram to 29 gram, 30 gram to 34 gram, 35 gram to 39 gram and 40 gram to 44 gram. And the frequency corresponding to it is given as 3 means there are 3 objects having the weight in between 10 gram and 14 gram. The frequency, the second one, 4 means there are 4 objects having weight in between 15 gram and 19 gram. It is going on there. So let's write cumulative frequency table. Tell me, what is the first thing to do? Yes, correct. We need to write the class intervals. To write cumulative frequency table, here it is given the grouped data. So we are going to find the class boundary. What is class boundary? We have learned in the previous class what is class boundary. Here we are going to find actually the upper class boundary. Class boundary means it is the true class limits. How we will find the true class limits? By finding the adjustment factor. Now tell me how to find the adjustment factor. You can see here for the first class interval 14 is the upper class limit, 15 is the for the second class interval, 15 is the lower class limit. It is not continuous. So we need to find an adjustment factor. 15 minus 14, what we have done? The lower class limit of the second class interval minus upper class limit of the first class interval by 2. It is 1 by 2, it is 0.5. So here 0.5 is the adjustment factor. Then what to do with this adjustment factor? We will subtract adjustment factor from the lower limits and we will add adjustment factor with the upper limits. So the first class interval we can rewrite it as 9.5 to 14.5. We subtract the adjustment factor of 0.5 from 10 and we add it with the upper limit 14. Then how it will be in the second class interval? It will be 14.5 to 19.5. This one is the continuous class interval and here it is not continuous. So we just change the non-continuous class interval to continuous class interval. But here to form the cumulative frequency table, we need only upper class boundaries. So we have to write the upper class boundaries as 14.5, 19.5, 24.5, 29.5, 34.5, 39.5 and 44.5. Now let's write the frequencies, the corresponding frequencies from the question. It is written here. Now, to write the cumulative frequency table, we are going to consider these upper class boundaries. So, as the next column, we are going to write less than 14.5, less than 19.5, etc. Yes, so here it is, less than 14.5, less than 19.5, less than 24.5. It is given here. To find these numbers, we just find the class boundaries. Let's find the cumulative frequency. So for the first one, the cumulative frequency is 3 itself. So the second one, weight less than, mass less than 19.5, it is 3 plus 4, it is 7. Now, third one, it is less than 24.5, it is, we have to add the three frequencies together. Otherwise, 7 plus 10, it is 17. How to find the next one? Yes, just add the 4 together, it is 17 plus 12, 29. What about the next one? 29 plus 6, it is 35. Mass less than 39.5 is 35 plus 3, it is 38. And for the last one, it is 38 plus 2, 40. So when you add all the frequencies together, you will get the same answer, 40. Just write. So this is how we will form a cumulative frequency table from a frequency table. Now we are going to construct a frequency table from the given data. What is given there? Yeah, a cumulative frequency table is given there. Less than 10, less than 20, less than 30, etc. It is going on. And number of students is also given here. Number of students means it is the frequency given. Let's draw the table. Yes. So the first one will be marks and the next one is the frequency. So how to form the class interval now? Less than 10, less than 20, less than 30, it is going on here. To write the class interval, we need the length of the class. Very simple way is here. Just find the difference between these two numbers. 10, 20 and 10, it is 10 itself. 30 and 20, it is 10 itself. 40 and 30, it is 10 itself. So the difference between these all is a constant number, it is 10. So we can assume that the length of the class interval may be 10. So we are going to consider the class interval as, instead of less than 10, we will write it as 0 to 10, Instead of less than 20, we can write it as 10 to 20. Then it will be 20 to 30. The next is 30 to 40. Again, 40 to 50. And the last one is 50 to 60. Now look at the frequencies given. 6 means the frequency 6 means there are 6 students who got less than 10 marks. So 0 to 10, in between 0 to 10, there are 6 students. Now, what about this? Less than 20, 15 means there are 15 students who got less than 20 mark. Less than 20 means starting from 0 to 20, it is 15 students. But what we need here? We need here the frequency or the number of students who got in between 10 and 20. How to find it? Correct. Just subtract these two frequencies together. 15 minus 6. It will give you the number of students who got the mark in between 10 and 20. So what is 15 minus 6? It is 9. Again, the same thing. Less than 30, it is 30 students. What is the meaning? Number of students who got less than 30 mark. But here we need the number of students who got the mark in between 20 and 30. So here also we are going to find the difference between 30 and 15. The consecutive, we are finding the difference between the consecutive frequencies. So there are 15 students in between 20 and 30. Then tell me, how many students will be there in between 30 and 40? Correct. 39 minus 30. So there will be 9 students who score mark in between 30 and 40. What will be the next one? It is 53 minus 39 equal to 14. And the last one is 70 minus 53. It is 17. What is the meaning? There are 17 students who got the mark in between 50 and 60. So, a cumulative frequency table is given. And from the cumulative frequency table, we form the usual frequency distribution table. In this question, we are going to form a frequency distribution table from cumulative frequency table. A cumulative distribution table is given and the frequency, cumulative frequency, is also shown here. We are going to form the frequency distribution table. What is the first thing to do? Yes, we need to find the class size, class length, right? How to find the class length? Yes, just find the difference between these numbers. You can find a common number here, right? 7 minus 4, it is 3. 10 minus 7, 3. 13 minus 10, 3. 16 minus 3, it is 3. So, we are going to write the class interval as 1 to 4, 4 to 7. 7 to 10, 10 to 13, 13 to 16, etc. So, let's write the frequency distribution table here. Here it is age. Then, frequency. How to write the class interval? It's starting from 1 to 4. Then it is 4 to 7, 7 to 10, 10 to 13 and 13 to 16. Now, how to find the frequency? Below 4, 0 means the number of students who is having less than 4 age. It is 0. So, when you are converting it into frequency distribution table, the number of students between the age 1 to 4, it is 0. Now, below 7, 85 means the number of students having less than 7 years of age, it is 85. Then, when we convert it, the first one, 1 to 4, there is no student. So, in between 4 to 7, there will be 85. What about the next one? Below 10, 140 means including the previous one, including below 7, right? So, how to find it? 140 minus 85. What is 140 minus 85? There are 55 students whose age is in between 7 to 10. Next one, below 13 means you have to include 10, below 10, below 7 and below 4, right? But here we need the number of students having the age in between 13 and 10. It is 243 minus 140. How many are there? So, there are 103 such students are here. Now, the last one, below 16. Here it is 300, but the meaning is that 300 means below 16 means we have to include all the frequencies together. Here we need the number of students in between 13 and 16 years of age. It is 300 minus 243. It is 57. So we form the frequency distribution table from the given cumulative frequency table. Two more questions are given there. State the number of students in the age group of 10 to 13. Look at the frequency distribution table. The number of students in the age group of 10 to 13, it is 103. The answer is 103. One more question. State the age group which has the least number of students. Least number of students. Which is the least one? 0, 0. Look at the frequencies. Here 0 is the least one, right? So, it is 1 to 4. Thank you, dear students. Keep yourself safe.